problem.
Hey guys, so welcome to another hashtag Falisha video. I finally decided on a hashtag. I forget who it was, I'm so sorry, but someone tweeted me one day and was like, hey, you should have hashtag Falisha, like by Felicia, but Falisha. And I was like, oh my gosh, that is literally perfect. So from now on, if you have any requests or you take any screenshots, be sure to use hashtag Falisha in your post, and that way I can see it.
That's her.
So this video is a very exciting video, and it is a Halloween party, like, epicness, basically. It has DIY snacks, DIY treats, DIY decor, and also some costume ideas if you just have no idea what you want to be for Halloween. And the epicness doesn't even stop there. This is a collab video with three other girls. There is Meg, Sierra, and Lindsay, so be sure to check out their channels. The links will be in the down bar. And what else? Do I have anything else I want to say? Like this video if you like it. Like it. I'm waiting for you to like it. Go like it. That corner? That corner. That corner. And again, be sure to use that hashtag Falisha. Not by Falisha. Be like, hi Falisha. Falisha. Hi Falisha. Bye Falisha. Hi Falisha. Really? May.
Air conditioning.
Hope you guys like this video and I will let you watch it.
Bam!
So first, let's start with the costume ideas, and these are my go-to costumes every single year because I think they're super cute and really easy to do. So the first one is a baseball player, and I don't know if you guys know this, but I am a huge St. Louis Cardinals fan, so I really like this outfit. But anyways, all you need is a plain V-neck t-shirt. I just have a red one, and then some white shorts, and also some matching red knee-high socks. Whatever baseball hat that you want that goes with your team. And then I found this baseball bat at Target for really cheap, and I already had my Converse, so really all I had to buy was the baseball bat and the socks, so that was really easy. And the second costume is a schoolgirl, and I particularly love this one because I get to channel my inner Serena Vanderwoodson from Gossip Girl. I am obsessed with that show. But anyways, it's so easy also, so all you need is a plaid skirt. You can kind of find these anywhere nowadays, and then a white blouse button-down type of shirt with a tie. Just borrow one from your brother or your dad or something, and you guys know I love my knee-high socks, so of course I was excited to wear those. And then I'm just wearing some black Keds for some sneakers, and that's it. So yeah, let's move on into the DIY decor, which is a candy corn banner. So go ahead and take yellow, orange, and white paint, and you're basically just going to paint plates like a bullseye type thing, and I promise it'll make sense later, but just basically paint it like this, wait for it to dry, and then cut it into equal parts, maybe like six, basically just into triangles. Then after you hole punch two little holes in it just like that, all you have to do is take some string or yarn or whatever you want to string it with and loop it through the hole punches and then tie two ends on the sides, and then you have this awesomeness candy corn banner. Like, how cute is this, guys? I'm kind of obsessed with it. It's so, so cute. So that is the first DIY. And now we're going to make some mummy cookie pops. Oh my gosh, they are so good. You guys have to try them. So grab some double stuffed Oreos, and can we talk about One Direction on the front for a second? Yes, perfection. Okay, anyways, so now I'm taking some cake pop sticks and just sticking them in the Oreos. And then to make less of a mess, I'm taking the white chocolate and putting it in a Ziploc bag. So that way I can easily just squeeze it kind of all over the Oreo. And then I'm taking some candy eyeballs, which you can find in the baking section, and I'm just putting them on.
Holla!
So that's how you make the mummy cookie pops, which are amazing. And last but not least, we have the witch's broomsticks, and these are so cute. So anyways, all you need are some pretzels and some string cheese, preferably the variety pack, because that way you can get some orange color in there. But anyways, take your string cheese and cut it into three equal parts, and then you're gonna make two slits on one side and then flip it to its side and then make one slit, if that makes sense. Kind of is a little confusing, but basically when you're done, just kind of spread it out to make it look like the bristles of a broom, and then stick your pretzel in it, and it is seriously one of the cutest appetizers I think I have ever seen. So my epic Halloween video. I really hope that you guys liked this. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments what you're doing for Halloween. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Those are bombs.
Halloween.
Really bomb.
Like bomb.
Halloween.